Okay, folks, how's it going? Those of you who don't know us, I'm Eric Lockamy. That's Pat White.
How's it going, guys?
Anyway, we're on our way to Stockade Lake. We're going to take you guys ice fishing, hopefully catch some pike, maybe some bass, some panfish today. Now, we're out on early ice, so there's some things you got to do. You got to take a spud bar, make sure you got enough ice out there. Dress warm. Obviously, you can see we have our appropriate attire on. Good boots, good gloves, I recommend. Anything else, that's completely up to you. But I suggest windproofing and waterproofing everything you have. Be careful there on the ice. Wear your cleats. Once we get to the lake, we'll show you some more, hopefully. What we use, we pull that little sled there in case you want to move 400 or 500 yards down and still fish easy. It's our Eskimo auger. As you can see, we have a wide array of tip-ups. Use whatever you want, whatever you're comfortable with. It doesn't even matter. Now, the two Vexilars, Pat, what you want to tell us about these two things?
These are just the basic FL8 models, you know, bottom line, but they work great. They work great. You know, I have two different transducers on this one. This is the basic transducer that comes with them. And then I have the pro transducer on this one, which picks up everything so much more. It's way more sensitive than this one is. You can pick up 120 feet of water just like that. I mean, you can pick up an 1/8 inch lure or jig on the bottom and it'll register.
By the way, that is Pike Master Pat. Hopefully today you will see why his name is that.
We'll see what happens.
I am, unfortunately, the Bushman from X-Rock. Pat, why don't you show him? 101.1 and 103.5, baby. Rock station. Listen to it. But anyway, now we'll show you how these Vexilars work once we get some holes popped and all that good stuff. Right now, Pat's going to tell you about the rods he uses and what he likes to use and why he likes to use them. Me, right now, I haven't been doing it for 20 years. I just got me a $14 setup from Walmart. I'm jigging for panfish right now. But Pat here, he's got a few things to tell you. Go ahead, buddy.
Right now I'm rolling what I got on my bucket here. Right now I'm rolling, it's not too expensive, you know. It's if you're wanting to really kind of just start out, this is a heat wave 13 fish rod. It's pretty decent. It's super light. It's got a nice center balance on it.
And how's the action on that thing?
Put a spring bobber. It's a lighter action. It's not super heavy, you know. It's got a nice little backbone to it. And then I have a couple Shields rods on here. Of course, I got the Haley jig on here. This is one of my favorite jigs to fish with. I've caught trout, bass, pike, you name it. I've pretty much caught it through the ice on this.
And the jigs too. I mean, that's completely up to you people as well. I mean, whatever you like to use. We have our lures that we swear by, and I'm sure you do too. But I guarantee you, you'll see some fish caught on that lure today.
Yeah, I got a variety of, this is another 13 fish rod. This is the Sonicor. This has got the leech fluter spoon on it. Clam, that's good.
Here, let me get a better look at that. There you guys go.
Gold color, that's a good.
So why you like them Shields rods then?
These Shields rods are pretty decent. This rod right here, it's probably one of my favorite panfish rods because it's super, super sensitive. I mean, it's I can tell when I'm getting a light bite. It's got a built-in spring bobber also, but I mean, you can.
And what's that run normally?
I think this one is $30 maybe.
So see, so that's not bad, people.
$30 and it's a decent rod.
What you using for a jig on that bad boy?
It's another Haley.
Okay. So anyway, people. He swears by those Shields rods, but like I said, whatever you think you need. Anyway, it's going to get a little loud here. We're going to pop a couple holes. I'm going to get some water out for our minnows. And then then we'll go from there. What I suggest, hang on, Pat. What I suggest is you guys go, like we're going to run a string down this weed line here for some pike and some bass. We're going to pop probably about 20 holes right now so we can jig for some panfish too. Background, you can hear him popping some holes. Anyway, what we're using for bait today on our tip-ups, we're using shiners that we get from the roosters. They have great bait there. Check them out. I'm going to be using regular wax worms, and Pat the Pike Master swears by red spikes. So we'll see today. Trust me, you'll see some fish get caught. Anyway, we're going to get to drilling some holes, and we're going to get to fishing, people. That's why you use the sled. Now that we got some holes popped for some tip-ups, we're gonna go get some lines in the water. We're going to set up one here. We're going to set up one over there. As you can see, Pat says you can see the weed line. We're fishing about 6.5 feet of water here. And on that weed line, it kind of bumps out a little bit right here. So we're setting up perfect. We're going to set a couple up over on the other side, just in case. As you can see, it looks nice out here. Wear your cleats if you have them.
Yes, it is very slick. My cleats blew apart on me last time I came out, so I'm in the process of getting a new pair, and it's a little slick today.
That's what happens when you're two broke fishermen. But anyway, you know, you do what you can. You learn how to keep your balance. And anyway, here, what you doing here?
This is a little trick I learned. Take a little rubber band.
Okay. Want a shiner?
I will in a second. I will get set up first.
Okay.
All right.
So what exactly are you doing?
I'm sticking my depth weight on here to see how much, you know, how deep we are here.
Okay.
Drop it down. I let it hit bottom. See, we're at bottom right there. And then I usually take it probably about that far
off. 2.5 feet off bottom?
Something like that.
Okay.
You know, it just depends. I mean, that's your preference. If you want to fish a foot off the bottom, you can put a fish foot off the bottom. If not, you know, that's...
So what you say, we're probably in about 6.5, 7 feet of water there, huh?
Yeah, close to it.
Okay, perfect.
So you take this.
Yep.
Instead of having to use a pinch weight, because they fall off all the time.
Yeah.
Take this, put it on your line like this. Pull it back through itself. If my fingers will work.
Here, let me get up in there. Get a better view of what you're doing. Okay, and why'd you put that on there?
That's to mark your depth. So when you, if you catch fish and it runs you out, you can automatically come back in, set your tip up back up, and you'll be at the exact same depth you were at when you caught that fish.
Perfect. So you ready for shiner now?
Yeah.
Want a big one or a little one?
It doesn't matter. I'll take a big one.
Okay. How about this guy right here? Oh.
I usually hook. People hook them different. Some people will hook up here above the dorsal fin. I usually try to hook right behind it.
Okay.
Some people will cut the tail to make it swim differently. I usually just let them roll.
Let them swim free.
Yep.
Down the hole it goes. He's going to wind it up to where he's next to that blue rubber band there. And that's one in. So anyway, we're going to get back to setting up some tip-ups here. And we'll get back with you when a flag comes up or when we start jigging. Okay, people, we're in the middle of setting up still. And we got a flag already, so we're going to go check this out and see if we got anything. We almost had all of our tip-ups set up, and a flag goes up. Well, I don't see any spinning. Might have just been a big minnow.
Line straight out, so there might be something on there.
All right, check her out. Nope, nothing. All right, well, false alarm, guys. We'll get back to you when we start jigging. We got one running. All right, we're gonna let the pike master come over here right now. We got one running. Check her out. See her running? Yeah, Pat's coming. I was just setting up my Vexilar right there. I was gonna start jigging for some panfish, but obviously we got something on a flag already. It's running still, bro. Let's go. It's been running the whole time.
Put your line on there.
Did you get him?
Yeah.
All right. Let's see what this is.
Bass.
All right.
Nope, you spit me. Nope, you still on there.
Well, just so you guys know, we eat fish around here. So if you see us putting stuff in a bucket, that means we're going to eat it. I'll show you how to cook it later. What you got there? Did I say pike?
Bass, I bet.
Well, I told you. And that is why we call him Pike Master Pad, bro. I mean, not a huge guy, but we'll get some meat off that fella. They're down low. They're down low. Yeah, don't be reaching out on camera. So see, when they swallow it down, that's why you have needle nose hooked on us. You can pop that thing out, and we're going to keep them anyway. Here, want me to hold the mouth open?
Just be careful he don't get you. That's why.
Yeah, I know. Trust me, we're seasoned vets at this shit.
Need to invest in some spreaders. Let go, bitch.
There you go. Throw him on the ice. We're going to keep him. Nice little guy.
Down.
Probably 3.5 pounder or so. Anyway, that's why you set tip ups, people. All right, Pat. Look up, brother. Good job. Now you got a lot of running to go get another minnow. That'll teach you.
And there's all this line.
Right? Anyway, haven't even been here 20 minutes, people. Already got a pike. Stockade Lake, by the way, did I tell you that's where we're at? Yeah, fishing
South Dakota.
Fishing 5 or 6 feet of water. Anyway, we'll be back at you. I'm going to show you a little bit of this right here. Drop her down the hole. Turn her on. I'm using shallow one for my setting. As you can see, we're fishing about 5 feet of water. Looks like we got some suspended fish. Got her down there. Now listen, people, if you're in a hole and you ain't catching nothing when you got 20 holes popped, then go somewhere different. You can see it on there, jig popping up and down. Nothing yet. One pike already, though. Bring it up a little sometimes. Down, do whatever you want. Pistol grip, you know, as always. Grip it like this so you can feel stuff at the end. Give it some jigs. You know, sometimes I jig 18 inches. Sometimes I jig 2 inches. Just all depends. Sometimes you don't need much to get them to bite. Anyway, I'm going to jig a few holes like this. You understand how to do it, right? Anyway, if you don't, you'll learn. Oh, I got one. Hang on a second. Let's see what we got here. Now, not a huge one, but it's a bluegill. Sometimes it's tough like this. Sometimes you got to find the exact one they want. Sometimes you have to use waxies or something else. All depends. Anyway, if I catch some, I'll come back. A little deeper water here. Fishing about 10, 12 feet. Got the white plastic on again. Okay, we're back down a hole now. Jigging a Mackie plastic, red in color. On a gold jig. Oh, just missed one. If you can't get him to bite this red here, I'm probably change up to a green or a white. All three are good colors. Another little guy, but you know, they all count. Anyway, they're biting pretty decent. Like I said, they're anywhere from an inch off the bottom to about a foot off the bottom here at Stockade today. Anyway, try to catch some more. Here, fishy, fishy. Got the white 3-ball on right there on a gold jig head. Here we are, another hole fishing about 5 foot of water. Got fish down there. See if they'll bite this red lure here. All right, people, went to a different hole, dropped it right to bottom, brought it about an inch off bottom in this 5 foot water hole. Just got me another bite in the same little hole here. There we go, folks. Another little bluegill. Anyway, what I'm doing is hitting on bottom and bringing it about a reel up, so I'm fishing about a foot off bottom in 5 foot of water. So they're suspended at about 4 feet. Hopefully we catch some bigger ones. And like I said, I just got hammered again down this hole, fishing about 4 foot in 5 foot of water, I'm telling you. That's where they seem to be today. How's it going over there, Pat? Catching any fish? Gonna go over here to Pat. Yeah, a little slip on the ice. That's why I said cleats, people. Trust me, we'll get some. You know, when you're broke and you can't afford stuff, that's what happens. We're gonna go over here and watch Pat jig a little, check out his Vexilar. Holy, yeah, cracking under my feet, people. That's what happens sometimes.
Yep.
Ice is talking. We got the bald eagles in the background talking.
Pat's fishing in about 7 feet of water, people. And I don't see anything flashing. Some bubbles at about 2 or 3 feet.
I haven't hit the bottom yet, though. I like to bounce the bottom a little bit.
Okay. Let's go over here and see what we got going on. Oh, she doesn't look like she's spinning, though. Yeah, sorry for that brightness. We're dealing with the two people.
It's been spun, though, so it's...
All right, take this. Let's see.
See how that line is. Looks like there might be a little tension on there.
Oh, nope. Don't feel anything.
Looks like he might have ran you out.
He took a lot of line.
Yeah, he did. It's been up for a minute. There might still be something. Nope. Did he get shiner?
Oh, he did.
Ah, ran into the weeds. Probably bass.
Well, we got another flag up over here. It's madness right now.
Anyway, I had something. He ran about 20, 30 foot of line, put me in the moss. Gandhi. As you can hear, I'm sliding across the ice. Why? Because I don't have my spikes. But I'll get them. Spinning? What? Get him?
No.
Oh.
He ran me all the way to the reef. Nope, there's something on there.
Oh, nice.
Oh, yeah, there's definitely. Oh, my gosh, dude.
Good?
Oh, yeah. I think we almost got bigger than the other one.
Good.
Holy shit. This one might be a fucking reach in and pull your fucking finger off fucking type thing.
That's what we want. Don't be scared.
No, I'm not scared. I like to finesse them. Watch out.
Just trying to get that moss out of there. Ooh.
That's my leader right there. That's why I was letting him run a little more.
It's okay. We'll get it. As you can see, we set up on weed lines, people. That's where these fish like to troll right now. See what we got here. That's why he's the pike master. Me, I just horse it in. Grab him fresh and green and get bit. He's not. He's a 6 pounder.
Yeah, he's only about 5 pounds, I bet.
But hey, better than no pounds, my friend. Get his head. Eyeballs, yeah, gills. There you go. Grab him by the eyeballs and gills, people. Looky there.
That's a fucking 5 pounder there, bud.
Yeah, looky there, people. That's a nice 10 pound pike. Telling you. Pat, pike master. Look at that. Hate this guy. He always catches all the pike. Anyway, we're going to get this guy unhooked and get back to fishing, people. Like I said, Stockade, look at the
coming.
Mouth.
I wasn't getting him.
Look, hang on. Let's get a shot down that fucking gullet.
Look at that. He ate it. There's
no. If you open that up a little bit, as you can see, people.
He swallowed it.
His belly.
Ow!
See, that's how you get bit.
That's how you get bit.
So anyway, we're going to have to pop this line probably and tie us on another hook. So we'll be back with you guys with some more action. We are going to go weigh this thing right now. But as you can see, that is not a bad pike for Stockade Lake. We're guessing it weights. He guessed 15. I guess 13 and a half. So why don't we get over there and get this thing weighed? We'll go from there. Pike Master Pat has another flag up. So we're going to go check and see if anything's biting on it. Ice is cracking all under me as I'm heading over there. Good times. Yeah, the other one wasn't spinning either.
Sure. Just a hitter and quitter.
Yeah, nothing on there. Got anything? All right, come on over to mine.
It looks like there's some tension on it.
Yep, there was. Why not?
Oh, Randy, you took the minnow too. Slowly turning. Oh yeah, there's something on there. He's tugged her. Uh-oh. Here you got a knot. He's on there, he ain't going anywhere.
Uh-oh. Get that knot out if you can. Oh, he's a bass, baby.
Nope, Pike, I can see him.
Oh, little guy. Hey, right on the hole!
That's our baby!
Let him go. He'll get bigger. Down he goes. Of course, Pike Master Pat caught himself another one. Of course, right here, you know, Pike Master Pat. Yep, caught himself another one. We're gonna go check it out real quick. I had a flag that popped up a little bit ago across the lake. I went over and checked it, didn't have anything. Popped back up here, so we're gonna run over and check that real quick. There is our little mess of three pike, people. Not bad for a day, not along with the other bluegills and everything we had. Well, folks, it's about an hour before dark. We're just wrapping some things up, jigging now. We caught bass, bluegill, crappie, perch, pike today. Anyway, got some bluegills in a bucket that are big enough to eat. We're going to leave these tip-ups here, start hauling some stuff out. Get you guys a picture of these three pike we got here whenever I get up closer. And run over here and grab the auger. You know, always be safe out here when it's this early ice. I mean, we caught a bunch of little guys that we had to throw back. But you know, catching fish is catching fish. Are the three pike that, of course, Pat, the Pike Master White, caught. Like I said, it's Stockade Lake, people. Beautiful out here. You'll catch a ton of fish. You might not catch a ton of big fish, but you'll catch a ton of fish. Seem to be always biting. We're 5-6 feet of water today. Anyway, we'll wrap it up to you here in a little while and let you know how it ended up for a total.
Some tip-ups from a distance. Pat's getting some stuff ready to bring up.
But you know, it's a pretty good day. We caught fish.
Three pike, one really nice one. Bunch of bluegills. Pat caught quite a few crappie and perch. We each caught a couple bass. I mean, it was a good day.
Anyway, we'll wrap her up here shortly.
Maybe I'll give you guys a recipe if you're lucky. You're going to have to watch another episode if you want to learn how to clean up pike.
I'm running out of storage space and stuff like that. Sorry about that. We'll get that fixed next time. From Pat White, the Pike Master.
I try.
And Eric, the Bushman Lockamy. We'll be back with you when we can. Thanks, man. Hope you guys liked it.
Keep Stockade.
Just to let you know, we're in a 2003 Honda Civic. Everything fits in there nicely. We're wrapped up for the day. We had a good day. Say bye, Pat.
You guys have a good evening.
And I say bye, too. I got to download some files off of this thing, get them on the computer so we can get it out to you guys. And then I'm going to do a recipe or two as well, let you know how to cook these fish. And if you keep watching, we might just show you how to clean up some of these pike boneless. Anyway, have a great time, guys. Hopefully you watch it, like it, and watch us again.
Keep lines tight. Catch all the fish.